First at 6, a major push for so-called vaccine passports, a way to prove you're vaccinated.
Some believe a vaccine passport could be the key to jump-starting travel and leisure activities. The push coming from the United Kingdom, which is proposing an internationally recognized document to the G7, a group which includes the United States and Canada.
For now, it's just talks, but a local health technology company is part of a project taking a look at the idea.
41 Action reporter Sarah Plake explains.
A lot of people may be itching to go to that concert or out of town, but there are still fears about who's vaccinated against COVID-19 and who's not. But your ticket in to all the places you love could be right on your phone. Major corporations like Cerner right here in Kansas City are working on a project that will digitally store your COVID-19 vaccination records. It's called the Vaccination Credential Initiative.
It will be a stimulation for our travel economy and for people getting out and about again.
Mark Ebbets, president of Shelton Travel Service, says this will be a more convenient way for people to prove they got a COVID vaccine, if they're required to, before they go on a cruise, get on a flight, or go overseas.
It's got to be big, and it will be big once it comes out. They want to be sure that you're vaccinated, and the way they're, or not COVID. And the way they do that now is you have to take a COVID test anywhere from 3 to 5 days before you go someplace.
Your records will be encrypted on a QR code, like a barcode, that is unique to you. Cerner compares it to the Google or Apple Wallet feature, where you digitally store your credit cards, concert tickets, or airline tickets. Or if you don't have a smartphone, you could get that QR code mailed to you to print out.
Embedded in that QR code, that crazy little box thing of squiggly lines, will actually be the core information about who you are and where you received your vaccine, which, you know, version of the vaccine, making that available in as modest a form, a small amount of information as necessary to do one thing.
Ebbets says he could see some people worrying about privacy, but he thinks the benefits of going back to a sense of normal are greater. Cerner said the companies involved, including Microsoft, will be testing this technology in the springtime to show that it's safe and private.
I'd say you'll see some real great demonstration projects in the spring, and hopefully by midsummer, you'll see this available and in wide use.
Sarah Plake, 41 Action News.
So after all that, the question you may have is, can businesses require vaccines before using their services, and will they? 41 Action News answered this question late last year. Two experts told us, yeah, businesses for the most part can require you to show proof you're vaccinated, almost like a no shirt, no shoes, no service rule, and it's already happening. Australian-based Qantas Airlines plans to require flyers to show proof of vaccinations once the airline restarts international travel later this year.